goal. Trinidad and Tobago scores again.
So we're here with Trinidad and Tobago's latest European-based professional, former national under 17 striker Justin Araujo-Wilson. Justin is speaking to us out of Czech Republic, where he has been for the last few weeks on trial before securing a two-year move with a club in Czech Republic. Justin, I'm relieved, excited. Tell us about your reactions to this latest move.
It's kind of overwhelming at first because I was here for a week and some days at first, and I was training really hard and trying to, you know, show my talents to the coaches and stuff. And I got a call saying that they want to offer me a contract, and I was just filled with joy. So it's truly a blessing, and I'm very grateful for it.
All right. Tell us about that process, you know, leaving Trinidad during the pandemic. Of course, you were in training with the national team. Then that training had to be halted because of the spike in the number of cases here. And having to get to Czech Republic, traveling during the pandemic, what was that like? You know, what were some of the obstacles you faced? What was the process?
Well, there's a lot of obstacles with the airline sometimes because some countries won't let you in because of COVID. And so I was stuck in airports a couple of times on standbys and stuff like that. I had to deal with certain obstacles, like I couldn't fly and I had to spend a day in England and stuff like that. But it all worked out for the best, you know.
And getting there now, you know, meeting the players for the first time, getting into the system at the training facility, what was that experience like?
Well, it was unbelievable because the facilities are amazing. Some of the things you see here, I haven't seen in China before, like how organized they are, how they take care of the fields and stuff like that. You know, and the dressing room, the energy in the dressing room is very positive and very uplifting. So when I got there, everybody welcomed me. And even when they saw me play, when I was having a little hard times, like I say, I'm not having a good day, everybody, you know, they were there for me and they made sure that, you know, I got to be more confident in myself and stuff like that. So it was good.
And in terms of, you know, developing as a young adult, as well as a footballer, being in a different country, different culture, language barrier, what has that been like so far for you? And how much are you embracing that?
Well, I'm trying to embrace it as much as I could, but it's also very difficult with language barrier and stuff. So I think it being football being a universal thing is like you have to really pay attention to what's going on in trainings and stuff, because if you don't, you'll miss it, and you know, you have to start over drills and start over sessions because of you. So at first it was very difficult, so I had to mature a lot faster and, you know, start to ask more questions and learn certain words in the language and stuff like that. So it just takes a little bit to get used to, but it was a good process.
For you personally, what do you think this will do for other players in Trinidad and Tobago? Some of your teammates who have been in the squad in the Trinidad and Tobago setup, you're opening doors for them. Obviously, they're seeing, you know, what the potential that is there in terms of opportunities for them. You've just come out of the under 17 system into the under 20s. You broke into the senior team training squad, and here you are now playing in Czech Republic in European football. What do you have to say about that?
Well, it's truly a blessing because there are a lot of talented players from around the 17 squad. And I know they're working very hard. And, their time will come as minded, and it's just to work hard behind closed doors, in front of cameras. Like in any situation, you just have to keep humble and keep a progressive mindset to keep working hard and stuff like that. And I think because of that, it really showed in my progress as a footballer, and I'm grateful for it.
You would have seen also, you know, the World Cup draw is out, the Trinidad and Tobago. We are aware of who we have to face in the first round. Are you excited about that? You know, what do you feel on your take on our chances?
I'm very, very excited. I'm very, very excited to come up against new obstacles and new challenges in my football career. And as a unit, our Trinidad and Tobago, I think we're a very talented bunch and we're able to do very well in the World Cup qualifiers.
Obviously, there's a lot happening now off the field of play. You would have been following that. You're aware of what is taking place. What are your hopes, obviously, for the best interest of Trinidad and Tobago football?
I just hope everything gets under control because you have a lot of players here who are working very hard and, you know, they want to put everything on the park for the country. So it's just for us to do our part and, like, on the other side of the football field, everybody has to do their part. So we do our part and we hope and pray that everything works out for our better man.
Well said. Justin, let me just take you back a bit now. You know, throughout your journey, starting at Fatima College, you were at Jablote for some time and you climbed the ranks into the senior team setup. Let's go through that. How did your days at Fatima, etc., shape you into what you are today?
Well, Fatima played a big role in my football development as well because the coaches and they believed in me. When times I didn't believe in myself, I was just playing football for how I like to play. And they gave me a call up, and on my first day in training, I did really well. So they told me the plans they had for me for my school football career, and they didn't let me down. So they executed what they had in plan for me, and I worked hard and tried to make them proud, my coaches and also my teammates. I tried to work hard for them as well, and it really helped me.
Right. And then as you moved up the ranks, you got into the under 17 team. You had the opportunity to work with two of the country's most celebrated strikers in Kenwyn Jones and Stern John. What was that like? How much you think that contributed to some of the success or the progress you made over the last couple of years?
Well, Stern John and Kenwyn Jones are players I looked up to as a youth, you know, watching them play for Trinidad and stuff like that. And all the advice they gave me will stick with me for my whole career. All the tips they gave me and stuff like that. It was very inspirational to play under those two coaches. And I feel like my mindset going into the under 17 tournament last year, where I did well, it was mostly because of how they inspired me and how they pushed me to, you know, play to the best of my ability at all times.
And finally, I want to touch on something, Justin, whereby you're aware of the BLM movement that's happening right now. You are obviously, as a player coming from the Caribbean, in Europe, in Czech Republic, what were some of the things on your mind heading into that environment, you know, knowing what is happening across the globe now? And how have they embraced you, welcomed you, and made you feel part of the team setup, the family there so far?
Well, the team, like I said before, the team is very, they welcome you with open arms, and they were very kind to me. They worked with me, even though they didn't really understand a lot of the things I was saying. And so they were very, they comforted me, and they told me that they believe in me and stuff. So it was a very comfortable process, and moving over, and no problems at all.
What is your take though on this whole Black Lives movement? Seeing that you're a black player across there now, trying to make something for yourselves in that sort of environment.
I see it all.
Do you intend to try to make you intend to play your part? Obviously, you're a young footballer that is succeeding, and it's part of your journey. So you will have to face some of these things. And how do you look forward to facing it head on and getting through the obstacles?
Well, in my opinion, about that. Sorry to go back to the question, but in my opinion, right is right and wrong is wrong, and I will use my platform as a professional footballer to encourage and to, you know, tell people to do the right things.
And what are some of your ambitions now that you've gotten the opportunity, you've worked hard to reach where you are today? What are some of the goals you've set yourself now looking ahead?
It's just to work hard for my club, you know, produce and score a lot of goals, you know, and get results, you know, make my family proud. Make my agents proud, who gave me this great opportunity to be out there and, you know, to just represent Trinidad to the best of my ability and show people what I can do and show people what Trinidadians can do, because Trinidad is a very talented place where footballers come from.
Perfect. All right, Justin, we want to thank you for this opportunity to hear your views. We want to wish you the very best looking ahead to the rest of the year, and keep it up. Thanks.
Thank you.